Hey there, it's Andrew. So let's say you've got a device, an SD card, USB flash drive, etc., and all of a sudden the drive becomes raw. Well, you remember you can just run CHKDSK on it to fix it, but you get the error message, CHKDSK is not available for raw drives. Well, today I'm going to show you how to fix it. I'm going to walk you through step by step on how to fix CHKDSK not being available for raw drives. And make sure you stay until the end of the video because all the steps throughout are necessary for the best results. And by the way, are you dealing with this error right now? If so, I'm sorry, but leave a comment down below letting me know and subscribe to our channel for more videos just like this. Okay, so there's really two scenarios that you can run into when it comes to using CHKDSK on a raw drive. So first of all, you may have a new device, a new memory card, a new SD card in this case, that you've never used it before and the file system is still raw right out the gate. So of course you can't really use it at all, and when you try to run CHKDSK, it's not available for raw drives. And then secondly, and probably the most common, is you have a device or a drive or a card that you've been using for a while and it was working great, then all of a sudden it becomes raw with all of your critical files and data still on it. But in the end, the result is the same, right? You try to use CHKDSK, but because the system is raw, it's not available whatsoever. So the second scenario is obviously a lot more complex, as there's the added step of having to preserve the data from our drive. And so that's what we're going to be covering first. And when it comes to actually preserving your data, you really have two options. You can either restore from a previously made backup, or you can use file recovery software to pull the data off in real time. So of course, if you have a backup, use it, right? I mean, obviously that's going to be the best, most bulletproof course of action if you do happen to have one. But if you don't, the next best thing is going to be using file recovery software like Disk Drill to pull our files off of our drive, even if it's raw. Now, in the case of CHKDSK not being available for raw drives, Disk Drill is perfect as it has been designed with compatibility for corrupt drives in mind. It's able to read the data on the drive, bypass any errors present, and retrieve the data intact without formatting. It's got the ability to find virtually any file regardless of the file type and works on SD cards, USB drives, external hard drives and SSDs, you name it. So Disk Drill is perfect for a scenario just like this, and I'll be including a link down below in the description where you can download and install it on your Windows PC for free. But with that being said, here's how you can recover files from a drive with the CHKDSK not available for raw drives error. So first, of course, download and install Disk Drill from the link in the description. Step 2, connect your raw device to your PC and open Disk Drill. Now, because we are working with a drive that's technically corrupted, we're first going to create a byte-to-byte backup image of our drive and scan that instead. Now, to do this, simply navigate to the byte-to-byte backup menu, select your raw drive from the list, and hit Create Backup. Next, in the dialog box that appears, save your backup as whatever you want, and save it to a location that's easy to remember and has adequate storage to accommodate the backup, such as your desktop. Hit save and Disk Drill will begin the backup process. Now upon completion, click the home button and return to the recovery panel. Next, go up to the menu, select attach disk image, and select the backup you just made. This will load the file into the disk list, allowing us to scan the device for data without potentially harming the original files. Now with this complete, we can scan our drive by selecting the image we just imported and hitting search for lost data. As the drive scans, it will populate with files on the screen, which can actually be browsed in real time. But we'll wait for the scan is finished to move on. In step 4, once the scan is finished, you can review the found items with this button up here in the corner. Now, while you're reviewing the files found during the scan, you can actually preview them using the icon view, which is a good feature to have because it allows you to preview which files are completely intact and able to be recovered in full. You can also view the chances of file recovery here, which is a nice feature as well. Step 5, once you've found the files, add a check mark next to the ones you want. Hit Recover. Choose your preferred save location that's separate from your raw drive itself. And finally hit Next. And by the way, I should mention here that with the Windows version of Disk Drill, you can actually recover up to 500 megabytes of files for free without needing a pro version, which is pretty sweet. And with the recovery finished, you can navigate to your save location and all of your files will be there waiting for you. So Disk Drill is great. It's available for both Windows and Mac. It's available for free and allows you to preview all of your recovered files before you upgrade to a pro version. And if you do decide to upgrade to a pro license, it's not subscription based. So you buy it once, you have it for life. Okay, so now with all the files from our drive secure, we can move on to the second phase of the process, which is going to be restoring functionality to the drive. And there's really two ways we can do this. And the first way is going to be by using a free piece of software called TestDisk. TestDisk is an open source software that can restore corrupt file systems or individual partition tables, including FAT32, XFAT, and NTFS. Now, I will say here that it is a pretty technical procedure to use, but it's a solid alternative to formatting and it's free. So it's definitely worth a shot. So here's how you can use test disk to fix a drive that is raw. So first, of course, download and install test disk from the link in the description. Next, ensure your drive is connected to your PC, then launch the software. Next, select Create to create a new log file. Now in the next window that appears, select your drive that is raw. And if you need help identifying it, looking at the size of the drive can be helpful. Next, select your partition table type. In most cases, we'll require the Intel or PC partition, and press Enter. Next, select Analyze, then Quick Search. Then once the Quick Search ends, take a brief note of the list of partitions found, then hit Deep Search, and wait for it to finish completely. And when the search is done, note the partitions that didn't appear in the quick search list. Now, I only have one in my case, but any others that appear after the deep search are likely the raw partitions you're after. You can navigate through the partitions using the up and down arrow keys and selecting with the P key. And once selected, if you can see the actual partition files, then you know you've got the correct partition. Press Q to return to the home menu and repeat for any remaining partitions. Something else of note, if the raw partition has an asterisk next to its name, use the left and right arrow key to mark it as a primary partition without the boot flag. You'll see a P instead of an asterisk once it's marked successfully. Then once you're done marking all the raw partitions, select the write option from the menu to write the partition structure and press Y to confirm. Now after this, you may need to rebuild the boot sector as well. So to do this, navigate back to the main menu, go to Advanced, select Boot, then select the Rebuild BS option. Test disk will then load the tables, at which point you can press Y to confirm the rebuild. And after this, simply quit out of the application. So that's pretty involved. There's a lot of steps there, it's a little complicated, but it's definitely a great thing to try when it comes to restoring functionality to a raw drive. However, if that didn't work for you, then the only thing that's really left to do is format the drive. So formatting, of course, will erase all the partitions on the drive, but it will also completely wipe the file system and install a fresh, brand new one in its place. And to do this, we're actually going to be using a CMD command called diskpart, which just gives us a lot more precise control over the process. So here's how you can fix the error check disk is not available for raw drives using CMD. So first, go to your start menu, type CMD, right-click and hit run as administrator. Then enter your admin password if you're prompted. Then type the command diskpart and hit enter. Then type list disk and hit enter. Then from the list, identify which number corresponds to the drive you want to format and input that into the next command, which is select disk followed by that number. Then hit enter, then type clean and hit enter again. This has just formatted our drive. Next, type create partition primary and hit enter again. Type active and hit enter. And finally type format FS and TFS quick and hit enter. So now we have just formatted our drive and installed a new NTFS file system onto it, and it should be working good as new again. And by the way, to wrap all this up here, if none of this has worked for you, then what you're actually likely dealing with is some kind of damage to the drive itself, some kind of physical damage. And if that's the case, I would definitely recommend you consult with a professional recovery service as soon as possible. And with that, we're done. That is how you fix the check disk not available for raw drives error on your Windows PC. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you got something out of it, hit the like button down below and leave a comment letting me know as well. I always love hearing from you guys. But that is going to be it for today's video. My name is Andrew. Thank you for watching.